Hi, this video is from interview.com. interview.com is a job portal. If you're looking for a job, you can log on to interview.com and you can post your resume with us. In this video, I'm going to talk about very important basic Java entry question: difference between DOM parser and SAX parser. Parsers are fundamental XML components, a bridge between XML documents and applications that process that XML file. The parser is responsible for handling XML syntax, checking the contents of the document against constraints, that is DDT or schema. So I have a Java application and I want to read the XML documents. So I don't want to do it from scratch. I don't want to write any Java code to do that. There are parsers available, there are libraries available. So you have to provide the DDT, the schema, the constraints, I would say, and you can give the XML files. So based on this DDT and schema, these XML files will be converted into objects. So there are two parsers available: SAX parser and DOM parser. Let's see the difference between these two. DOM parser, it is tree of nodes. Here SAX parser is considered as sequence of events. DOM parser occupies more memory prepared for small documents because it loads the complete document into the memory, so it's very tough. Doesn't use any memory, preferred for larger documents. It goes by node by node. Slower at runtime, faster at runtime. Store as objects. Objects are to be created, so it'll have a callback and you have to create the objects. Programmatically easy, since objects need to write code for creating objects. So for events, each events it'll call you back and you have to create the object. Easy of navigation, backward navigation is not possible as it sequentially process the document. So these are the difference between SAX and DOM parser. Please remember, it's basically a parser which will help us to change this XML document and help the Java application to create the objects. Hope this video is useful. Thank you and all the best.